Hi, this is Elizabeth Postol from Boris FX. Recently, one user asked on the forum, why does a Nuke tracker exported from the Mocha does not work with the screen replacements correctly and results looks wrong? So now I would like to go over why this may happen and explain why you may prefer one or another method of exporting tracking data. So this is our footage where I'm just showing our Mocha Instagram page. But let's say we need to replace that to something else. Let's take Boris FX Instagram page as an example. So I just took a screenshot and now we can use it as a new screen. Let's launch Mocha and get started. First things first, we need to check what is happening on our screen. There is a common mistake that beginners make when they try to draw a shape around the phone, but there is actually some animation or video playing on the screen. If this is your case, then you need to draw a shape only around the edges of the phone, where nothing is changing. But in my case, this is just a still image, so I can draw a shape around the whole screen. Now let's set up our surface plane. If you're struggling with trying to find where the screen is actually ending, try to play with brightness and gamma to make the edge more visible. I believe it's somewhere around here. Now let's tweak all other corners. Don't forget to also choose to track perspective. Rename our layer to screen. And hit track forwards. After the tracking is done, we can check how good it is by setting a grid as an insert. Looks good to me. Let's turn that grid off and talk about exporting the data to Nuke. In general, there are three types of tracking data that could be exported. The first one on the list is alembic mesh. We won't be touching this one today because you would never ever need alembic for the screen replacements. But if you would like to learn more, there is already a great tutorial that Martin did and you can easily find that on Boris FX YouTube channel. The next one is Nuke 7 tracker that exports translation scale and rotation, and the last one is corner pin. Let's select this one and hit copy the clipboard. Now I can paste the data into Nuke, and I would also create a backdrop around this node and name that Mocha corner pin just to stay organized. Okay, I'll leave it here for now and jump back into Mocha to now copy the Nuke 7 tracker and show you the difference. Now I'm pasting the tracker and let's try connecting it to our new screen and to the source. You should be aware that this type of tracker does not set up to apply any motion to our image by default, so first we need to go inside the node and manually check what types of transformations do we want. On the transform tab, choose match move, cause that's what we want. If we try to play back the results, you'll see that now we have two problems. The first one is our new screen is completely in different place. The other one is that we don't have our shear and perspective changes. And that's because this is how a regular tracker works in general. It only can apply translation, scale and rotation changes to the image. So what can we do about that? Because the tracker contains data not only for one point, but actually for all four surface corners, we can generate corner pin from it. You need to select all four points, choose the type of corner pin you want to be exported. I prefer the baked one and hit create. Let's connect that to our image and see if that works. So now we have our shear, but screen is still in the wrong place. That's pretty easy to fix. Go inside the node properties and on the from tab, click set to input. And here you have it, your insert screen finally matched the original one. Although this method works, I do not usually use it for screen inserts, cause it requires too many clicks and unnecessary steps that could be skipped. Let's delete this and see what result we would get if we would use corner pin that was exported directly from the Mocha. We just connect your input to the node, merge that with the source, and everything works straight out of the box. No additional steps is required. But now you may think, is the regular tracker option completely useless? Totally no. Let me give you another example with the same shot. So here is the exact same tracker as we had before, but let's say now we want to create some simple callout. So I would create a text node, connect it all together, and enter some text. Something like subscribe to our Instagram. Okay, now we need to choose to what edge of the phone we want to connect the text. I open the tracker node, zoom in a bit, and see that this edge is tracker number 4. Now I need to enable only the translate checkbox and only for this point. don't forget to set Match Move on the Transform tab. Close everything, and let's see. Our text is linked to the corner, and we don't have unnecessary rotation and scale transformations. We can even try connecting both of these results together. I believe now you have a better understanding of the difference between these two export options and found out when it's better to use one over the other. If you learned something new, please give us a like and leave a comment. If you want more of these videos, follow the Boris FX YouTube channel or visit our forum in case you have any further questions. That's all for me. Bye-bye.